Do you know what hoisting is in JavaScript? Did you know that understanding scope and closures can help us better understand React hooks? In JavaScript, there are core concepts that you need to grasp if you want to be anything more than a junior dev. In particular, these include forciness, the different kinds of equality, immutability and why it's useful, and asynchronous behavior. And another of these fundamental concepts is scope and closure. That's exactly what we're about to explore together. These two connected notions deal with a variable's life cycle, its beginning and its end, and understanding closures can help you understand how state hooks work in React. So let's take a look at what is hoisting, what is a closure, and what can it be used for, and first, what is a variable scope? In short, a variable scope is the area of the code within which the variable lives and exists, its domain of existence, because like each of us, a variable is born, it lives, and one day it dies. For variables declared using let or const, it's easy enough to spot the birthplace. It's right where the variable is declared. If you try to access variables before this declaration, well, guess what happens? In fact, let's not guess. Let's try it out with this code. If I run this, well, unsurprisingly, it produces an error. On the other hand, if I put a console log after the variable's declaration, everything works fine. So once it is born, so to speak, the variable continues to exist. How long does that last? Well, as you probably know, JavaScript is built with nested blocks. Each block is usually delimited by curly brackets or braces. And generally speaking, that's where the block ends. The end of the block also delimits the variable's existence and ends its scope. Now, a quick aside here. In some cases, specifically in the case of a module, for example, the block can be the file itself. But in any case, the scope of a variable declared with let or const begins at its declaration and ends with the end of the block in which it's declared. If you try to redeclare it like this, well, it produces an error. And once a variable has been declared, it can also be accessed from the subblocks that follow. But there's a small exception to that. Can you guess what happens with this code? As you probably guessed, there isn't any error. Unsurprisingly, variable B is available in subblock. Now let's see what happens to variable A. The first block, the general block, declares A with a value of 41. The subblock declares a new variable with the same name. And this name temporarily overwrites, it masks or hides access to the higher level variable. When we first call console log with A, we access the subblock variable, which has the value 42. On the second call to console log, however, the subblock variable is no longer present because its scope is finished. And so the parent block variable is visible again. So console log returns 41. Now let's talk about hoisting. For var declarations, as well as for functions, things are slightly more complex than for let and for const. Now, as I've already said, I recommend that you avoid var and use const by default, and then use let when you can't use const. Now, if we take the code that produced an error with let, can you guess what it will do if we use var instead? Here, console log returns undefined and not an error. Why is this? Well, because variables declared as var have a scope from the top of the block in JavaScript, where they're initialized to undefined. This is what's called hoisting. Now, something similar happens with functions, with one major difference. Can you guess what this will do? Everything goes without a hitch. Not only is the hello function hoisted to the top of the block, it's also initialized before the code is actually executed. And there's a very good reason for this. There are cases when you need two functions to be able to call each other. One function will necessarily be declared before the other, but we still need both functions to be able to see each other. That's why function declarations are hoisted to the top of the block. Now, this does not work with ES6 function declarations that use the fat arrow syntax. If you test the following, things don't quite happen as smoothly. Basically, we've declared the function as a const variable, which can only be accessed once it's been initialized. Now that we've seen all these prerequisites, let's talk about closures. What is a closure and what is its purpose? Well, a closure is a way of encapsulating and exporting scope. It uses the way that scope works in JavaScript to store the state of a variable. Now let's take a closer look. We've seen that a variable is accessible from subblocks. So far in this video, we've mainly used neutral blocks, but these blocks can be of different types, such as loops or, of course, function declarations. Let's take a look at this example. Here, variable A lives within the function. The call to console log therefore outputs hello and not hi. Now, we're going to make this example a little more complex As you know, a function can return a value, and among the types of variables or values that a function can return, there is, of course, a function. Let's see what this does. Here again, console log outputs a's value. That's perfectly logical, as a continues to exist within the scope of the returned function. Now, let's make this example slightly more complex. Let's update a within the returned subfunction. Here, the first call yields 42, and the second call returns 43. And here we see something interesting. It's almost as if the f function is storing a's state. And that's what a closure is all about, closing or encapsulating. And although it would take too long to explain it in detail here, this is the kind of construction that React hooks are based on. Now, we've seen what scopes are, how hoisting works, and how closures work. In short, a lot of big words that hide concepts that are vital to understand. But did you know that there are 7 JavaScript concepts that you need to grasp to be an effective React developer? You can find out more here. I'll see you there.